So, good afternoon. My name is Y.V. Ramarao. So, today we start with statistics paper 1 for BSc, first year BSc, CBCS, Maths, Statistics, Data Science, MSDS students. So, you have statistics 1 paper as a combination of one of the core subject, and your statistics paper is related to mathematics related. So we start with today we start with the syllabus and framework, examination, curriculum and everything about your statistics paper. It is statistics 1 for BSc, first year BSc, Maths, Stat, Data Science. So, this is your syllabus as per your curriculum. So, this syllabus is common for first year, first semester CBCS, BA and BSc. So, what is CBCS? CBCS means Common Core syllabus for all the students, are credit based, choice based system. So in this CBCS curriculum, there are total 3 years of course, and every year is divided into semester wise. You have to learn in semester wise pattern. And every semester have 100 marks for and every semester have a separate core subject. That is, today this paper is paper 1, that is a descriptive statistics and probability. So it is divided into various components or parts. Total marks is for 100 marks. External exam or semester exam is held for 80 marks, and internal exam is for 20 marks. And there are two internals, and 80 marks for semester exam, and you have some practicals, practical softwares and others also, and 4 hours per week. Your workload is 4 hours per week. And this is and your curriculum or syllabus is divided into four units. So today we start with syllabus and basic concepts of statistics. So unit 1 covers about descriptive statistics, concept of primary and secondary data, classification of data, measures of central tendency, means arithmetic mean, median, mode, geometric mean and harmonic mean with simple applications, absolute and relative measures of dispersion, that is range, quantitative deviation, mean deviation, standard deviation and variance with simple applications, and importance of moments, central and non-central moments, their interrelationships, Shepard's correction for moments for grounded data, measures of skewness based on quartiles and moments, kurtosis based on moments with real life examples. So this is the curriculum or syllabus of first unit. So today we start with basic terminology or terms used in statistics. So mainly statistics is mainly used in all the applications where mathematical calculations and complex formulas and complex analysis designs, areas like Many other software applications are also used to along with statistics. So we start with some PPT today. So, introduction to statistics and basic terminology. Today we start with basic terminology used in statistics. So, there are number of terms used in statistics like data, statistics, population, sample data, like that. So what is data? A data consists of information coming from observations, counts, measurements or responses. So generally data is collected from various resources like observations, various observations, experiments. Counts means counting values or counting some information or data. All countable data or information. Measurements taken like in surveys and measurement taken in marketing, and responses means answers to or replies to the measurements. All these are generally termed as data collection or data. So statistics is the science of collecting, organizing, analyzing and interpreting data in order to make decisions. So why we require statistics? Means generally statistics is used in every area like management and all scientific engineering applications and all mathematical related and physical sciences and mathematical sciences. So it is mainly used to collect data and information, data in the form of some surveys or anything, and the collected data will be analyzed, and the collected data will be organized and analyzed and interpreted. Interpreted means by doing various number of calculations or various applying some various formulas or applying various taking some measurements and applying some find outs results from the data. So all these things are generally done with statistics. So there are four parts in the statistics. What are they? First one is called as collecting of data, or gathering of data or information. Now organizing means organizing the collected data in the proper way, in the meaningful way means we can easily understand, we can easily analyze it, we can easily sort out it, we can easily set it like that. And analyzing means based on the collected data we may take appropriate actions, we may take appropriate decisions when analyzing the gathered input or gathered data. And interpreting means processing of data to taken from the gathered data. So all these are generally required to take appropriate decisions by the top level management. Generally statistics is mainly used in economics and top level managers and organizations to take appropriate decisions and timely decisions like that. Next, another term is population. A population is the collection of all outcomes, responses, measurements or counts that are of interest. So what is a population? A population is the collection of all outcomes means results, responses means replies, and measurements or counts that are of interest. And a sample is a subset of a population. So what is a sample data? Sample data or a subset. Subset means a sample product or a sample collection of information is in the terms of subset. That subset is called as the sample data. Generally it is taken as subset is generally it is a small amount of key data or raw data or key data taken from the large amount of data to test for the statistic data. So populations and samples. So in this example we take some example with number of students and responses taken from them. So another important term we used is parameters and statistics. So a parameter is a numerical description of a population characteristics. A statistics is a numerical description of a sample characteristics. So we may use two terms called parameters and statistics. Parameter is nothing but which we simply used or taken some key data from the sample data or collection collecting data. So what are the different types of statistics? So what are the branches of statistics? Generally, the study of statistics has two major branches: descriptive statistics and inferential statistics. So descriptive statistics means involves the organization, summarization and display of data. Inferential statistics involves using a sample or to draw conclusions about a population. So the statistics is mainly divided into two core subjects or two core concepts: descriptive and inferential. So in descriptive, all the organizations, the top level managers and management departments, all these things are involved. And generally, these descriptive data is used to summarize that, to find out the summarize the data, or to find out the summary of the data, and we're doing various calculations like sums, averages, find out maximums, minimum, like that, and display of the data. And inferential statistics involves using a sample to draw conclusions about a population. Means in the inferential statistics, we may take some samples by using some subsets. Subset, what is a subset? Subset is nothing but a sample data which is used to test the population data, or which is used to test in the complete data or complete collecting data, collection data. So by using sample data, generally we may use ends with some conclusions, and we may take some appropriate decisions from the population or from the raw data. So generally inferential statistics involves to draw conclusions or to find out conclusions from the large collection of data. So data classifications, another term is data classification. So what are the different classifications used in So basically the data is divided into qualitative and quantitative. So data sets, what is data set? Data set is nothing but a sample data which is taken from the collecting data to test the given scenario or to test the given problem, like that. So data sets can consist of two types. First one is called as qualitative data and quantitative data. So qualitative means generally it consists of attributes, labels or non-numerical entries. So qualitative means all non-numeric data, like names, like cities, some brands, products, all these are called as qualitative data. Quantitative means numerical data, consists of numerical measurements or counts. Counts means summaries or numbers, digits. All numerical data is called as quantitative. And qualitative means it is non-numeric, like simple example, some product code or some like that. So examples, what are the examples of qualitative and quantitative data? So the grade point average of 5 students are listed in the table. Which data are qualitative data and which are quantitative? So this is a simple example used to find out which one is quantitative and which one is qualitative. So here there are two columns in the table: student and GPA. So 5 students are there. Students is generally a character or a string data, and GPA is a numeric data. So student is generally treated as a qualitative, and whereas qualitative and GPA is generally, it is a numeric decimal points, have it is a, generally treated as quantitative data. So levels of measurements. So there are number of levels are used at the, there are number of methods are methods and methods are used generally used to measure the data or information. The level of measurement determines which statistical calculations are meaningful. The four levels are measurements are normal, nominal, ordinal, interval and ratio. So what are the levels of measurement? Nominal, ordinal, interval and ratios. So these are called as levels of measurement. So why we require levels of measurement? It generally it is used to do some calculation operations. So depending on the problem given, depending on the problem used, we may use or choose various levels. One of the four out of these four. So nominal, we may choose either nominal, ordinal or interval, ordinal, interval or ratio. So this is the four methods or four techniques used while doing statistical operations or statistical measure problems. So first one is called as nominal. So nominal level of measurement, why we require these, means generally these four measurements, these four measurements are generally used to do apply to the various statistical applications or programs. Generally from the, in the least level we may take nominal measurement, and in the top level we may use ratio analysis. So for, we start with the first one, that is nominal level of measurement. So what is the nominal level of measurement? Data at the nominal level of measurement are qualitative only. So generally in nominal level of measurement we may take only qualitative, not quantitative. So generally these nominal levels of measurements are used using some used generally by using, they can be calculated by using some names, labels or qualities, and generally they don't have any mathematical calculations and compound computations can be made it. So in nominal levels generally we may use only labels. Labels means some characters or some strings, and some names or some qualities, qualities of the various qualities, like means high, low. There are different qualities at different generally nominal. In the nominal we may use all non-mathematical operations, non-mathematical operations. So examples are colors in the US flag, and the names of the students in your class, textbooks you are using this semester. So all these are non-nominal level of measurements. Generally these have non-numeric data or information. So second one is ordinal level of measurement. In ordinal level of measurement we may use either qualitative or quantitative. Either we may use both the qualitative or quantitative types of data. So in the ordinal level of measurement arranged in order, but differences between data entries are not meaningful. So generally in ordinal level of measurement the data or information are columns. A columnar data is arranged in some order, either in ascending order or in some descending order, like that. And generally the nominal, the ordinal level of data or information is generally, it is not in a proper, not arranged in a proper way, and it is also not meaningful to the audience. For example, class standings, freshmen, so like that, and senior, juniors, and numbers on the back of each player's shirt, and top 50 songs played on the radio. So these are arranged in some order, but it is very difficult to find out a particular data or information. So the third one is interval level of measurement. Data at the interval level of measurement are quantitative. A zero entry simply represents a position on a scale. The entry is not an inherent zero. So levels of measurement is next. The third one is interval level. Interval levels means in the interval level, the data is generally arranged in some order. The differences between data entries can be calculated. So in this interval level of measurement, or in this interval level of data measurement, we may find out, or we may take the differences between two values. Generally it is a quantitative data or measurement. So examples are temperatures, years on the timeline, Atlanta, like that. The fourth one is ratio level of measurement. So in the ratio level of measurement, the data are similar to the interval level, but a zero entry is meaningful. A ratio of two data values can be formed. So one data value can be expressed as a ratio. Generally in ratio level of measurement, the data is expressed in the form of ratios, by comparing one data with another data by taking ratios. So that examples are ages, grade point averages, weights, etc. So this is the summary of brief summary of the levels of measurement. So first one is nominal, ordinal, interval and ratio. So we use some parameters, or characteristics. So in the nominal, generally the data is categorized, data is displayed in some categories, and data is not in the order, means data is generally not arranged in some order, that is either in ascending or descending order. And subtract data values and determine if one data value is a multiple of another. So in the ordinal, generally the data is generally arranged in some categories, but the data is arranged in or displayed in some proper order, either in ascending or descending order. And in interval values, we may display the data in categories and arrange the data in order and subtract data values. And in the fourth type, that is ratio analysis, all the four parameters are taken into consideration. So how to start an experiment, or take experiments, or how to do some statistical calculations like that. So how to take experimental design and how to take experimental data or statistical data. So designing a statistical study, generally by using statistics, it is a tool, and by using statistics we may take various, we may collect sample data, raw data, and we analyze it. We can do various experiments on the data by using some subsets and sample data, and by using that, using that results, we may take various decisions by the top level managers and the organizations. So how to start a statistical study? So what are the guidelines or rules? First one is identify the variables of interest, means the focus, and the population of the study. So first of all, you have to gather all the data or information in the form of some numerical and that is quantitative and qualitative both, and in that you have to identify the variable, or it may be one variable or it may be multiple variable. What is a variable? A variable may change its value. A variable is generally change its value during the study. So variables of interest, that is, we have to select the select or focus the so from the population or from the data gathering, first of all, the first step is you have to identify the variable or variables, maybe one or more than one variable of interest, that is the focused value or the focused item or the focused data item which is to be observed, and the population of the study. Second one is develop a detailed plan for collecting data, means there are number of procedures and techniques are used to collect and gather the data or information or population. If you use a sample, make sure the sample is representative of population. Generally, after collecting the data and after collecting the variable, after identifying the variables, we have to take some samples. Samples means by taking some subsets of data. Sample is nothing but it is a some part of data to test the data, to test the sample data on the population of population, to take appropriate decisions by using. So there are number of techniques and a number of procedures are used generally to determine the collecting the collection of data. And third one is collect the data and describe the data and interpret the data and make decisions about the population using inferential studies and identify any possible errors. So this is the step-by-step procedure to identify or to do some statistical study, to do any statistical study. So what are the methods of data collection? So how to collect the data or information, how to collect the data or information, and which methods are used to collect the data or information. So in an observational study, a researcher observes and measures characteristics of interest of part of a population. In an experiment, a treatment is applied to a part of a population and responses are observed. A simulation is the use of a mathematical or a physical model to reproduce the conditions of a situation or process. A survey is an investigation of one or more characteristics of a population. So what are the methods? What are the different types of methods of data collections? Generally, they are generally observational studies by doing some experiments or by doing some simulations or by using some surveys. All these are the different methods. All these are the different techniques and methods to collect the data or information. So in the first one is observational study. In observational study, generally the researchers, why? Because researchers means generally researchers use statistics as a tool. Statistics as a basic tool. There are many other tools in statistics, like software tools are SPSS and other tools also there. We may discuss all these things. And generally, researchers use this observational study to do some statistical operations. So, second one is experimental. Experimental data collection. In this way, generally it is we may apply some part of population, we may apply some treatment, or we may apply some technique on the population or data population of the data, and we may observe taking some responses and observed the outputs or observations. So in the experimental way, we may take some part of the data or information or a population from the population, and then we may by using some queries or by using some experiments, by doing some experiments and taking responses means outputs, responses and means outputs, and observe the responses. That is another type of data collection. That is second type of data collections. Third one is simulation. Simulation is a use of mathematical and physical model to reproduce the conditions of a situation. Generally, simulation processes are generally used in mathematical and physical models. And fourth one is surveys. Survey is nothing but an investigation or gathering, asking some questions and gathering answers. Gathering answers or responses from the questions. Based on the questions and answers, we may take appropriate, we may find out various characteristics, and we may use various characteristics and attributes on the population, and we may take appropriate decisions. So generally the survey is two types, a census and a sampling. A census is a measurement of an entire population, and a sampling is a measurement of part of. Generally, surveys have two types, census and population. In the census, we may take all the populations, means population means the data or information, entire data or information. Sampling means taking only part, some part of the, some not complete part, not complete part of the data. Population, only we are taking some part of the population to test the sample data. So these are the example today's class. We may continue in the next class. Okay, thank you.